Johns, and I'm a senior, and I do poetry. May you ask me a question? If you really thought that you needed permission to ask me a question before asking me a question, you never would have found the guts to ask me that one. So you think about what you want. You think about what you know. And when you've decided what it is that you want to know, you can raise your hand and wait your turn just like everyone else. Good teachers know which questions to answer and which ones to ask, as illustrated by May You Ask Me a Question by Taylor Mally. He shared many of his experiences as a teacher with the world through his witty and insightful poetry. The selections for this program come from his book, What Learning Leaves. Next, we'll explore what it takes to be a seventh grade boy in Recipe for a Seventh Grade Boy. First, gather the ingredients. Take one pint of humility, a generous portion of tact, and several gallons of patience. Now, throw them out. You won't be needing them. In a large bowl, combine the memory of the elephant, an eagle's eye for detail, the speed, strength, and work ethic of a horse. Stir in the lab's loyalty, the ability of the cat to land on all fours, and the cackling loquaciousness of a gaggle of geese. Sprinkle liberally with the easygoing nature of a mule. Set aside and allow to mature. This is going to take some time, but it's worth it, because the finished product will serve all of the people of the world like no one else could. P.S. Keep the bowl. You'll need it later for the haircut. Technology is supposed to make life easier and more efficient for both students and teachers. However, computers are not human and do not possess common sense. Even with spell check, some hilarious results can happen. The Impotence of Proofreading by Taylor Mally. Has this ever happened to you? You work very hard on a paper for English class and you still get a glow raid. Like a D or even a D equals an all because you were the liverwurst spoiler in the whale wide word. Yes, this is a problem that affects manly students. I myself was such a bed spiller once upon a term that my English torturer my sophomore year said I would never get into a good colleague. Not just anal colleague, because I am not the kind of guy would be happy to just anal colleague. I need to be challenged, menstrually. I need a place that can offer me intellectual stimulation. Now, I know this might make me sound like a stereo, but I really thought that I could get into an ivory legal colleague. So if I did not improve, it gone would be my dream, going to Harvard, jail, or even prison in Prison, New Jersey. So I got myself a spell checker, and I figured I was on Salisi Street. But there are several mistakes that a spell checker can't catch. For instance, if you accidentally leave out word, your spell checker won't put it in you. And God, for billing purposes only, you should have serial problems with Tory spelling. Your spell checkoff might replace the word with one you had absolutely no intention of using. Because what do you want it to do? It only does what you tell it to do. You are the one sitting in front of the computer screen with your hand on the mouth going clip, clip, clip. It just goes to show how embargo one careless little clip of the mouth can be. So follow these two pieces of advice. One, there is no prostitute for careful editing. No prostitute whatsoever. And third, when it comes to proofreading, the red pen is your friend. In the final selection, we meet an eighth grade girl who affirms one of the most important things a teacher can teach, the ability to open one's mind, grow, and change. Like Lily Like Wilson by Taylor Mally. I'm writing the poem that will change the world, and it's Lily Wilson at my office door. Lily Wilson, the recovering like addict, the worst I've ever seen. So like that, the whole eighth grade started calling her Like Lily, Like Wilson, Like, until I declared my room a like-free zone. And she could not speak for days, but when she finally did, it was to say, Mr. Mally, this is so hard. Now I have to think before I say anything. Imagine that, Lily. It's for your own good, even if you don't like it. I'm writing the poem that will change the world. And it's like Lily Like Wilson at my office door. Lily is writing a research paper for me about how homosexuals should not be allowed to adopt. She's having trouble finding resources, which is to say, ones that back her up. They all argue in favor of what I thought I was against. And it took 4 years of college, 3 years of graduate school, and every incidental teaching experience I've ever had to let out only. Well, that's a real interesting problem, Lily. But what do you propose to do about it? That's what I want to know. And the eighth grade mind is a beautiful thing. Like a newborn baby's face, you can often see it change before your very eyes. Mr. Malley, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I think I'd like to switch sides. And I want to tell her to do more than just to believe it, but to enjoy it. The changing your mind is one of the best ways of finding out whether or not you still have one, or even that changing your mind is, it's like a parachute. It doesn't matter what you pack it full of, so long as it opens at the right time. Oh God, Lily, I want to say that you make me feel like a teacher, and who could ask to feel more than that? I want to say all of this, but manage only. Lily, I am, like, so impressed with you. So I finally taught somebody something, namely, how to change her mind, and realized in the process that if I ever change the world, it'll be one eighth grader at a time.